So, excuse how I look. I'm getting ready to take this wig off that I currently have, which I'm about to do, which I've probably already done a video on. If you want to know what wig this is, I'll link it at the top, or at least mention it in the description box. However, I did get a new wig, and it is from Hairspells. I'll put a title right here. If I'm a little discombobulated, as y'all know, I just woke up. I'll be loving a nap. But I just wanted to open it real quick, do a quick unboxing, at least for the beginning of the video. The hair is going to be 22 inches, and I believe it's deep wave. This is the packaging. Again, it's Hairspells. As y'all know, I love the satin bags. I feel like they're really good for the hair itself. Just with keeping it, you know, soft. Ooh. Oh, I might not be straightening this. I don't know. Okay, hold on. So this is, the satin bags help the hair keep, you know, help with keeping it soft. Just like, you know, how with our natural hair, we like to put, like satin bonnets on or have a satin pillowcase. It just, you know, helps with maintaining the softness of the hair and also just like the overall health and like, you know what I'm trying to say. So it comes with a net. Let me show you how the construction get off. All right. So like I said, it's deep wave. Oh yeah. It doesn't have a smell, has a regular hair smell. You know, I like that. This is the construction of the wig. So we have back clip, two side clips, and a front clip. And you do have the adjustable bra straps. It's like the adjustable strap. This is the hairline. The hairline looks like it was already pre-plucked. However, I'm gonna see if I need to pluck it some more. So I'm gonna take off this wig. I'm about to take another shower, you know, rejuvenate myself because I've been asleep all day. I'm gonna set it on, show y'all what it looks like. And then after that, I'm gonna try to customize it, see what I need to do, see what I don't need to do. Plus my camera battery is about to die. So I'm about to let that charge, you know, all that stuff. And then I will come back to y'all to let y'all know what I think I'm gonna do.
Line, he said them lows coming. Can't stand a broke nigga, let me hold something. Slide down your block, let off the whole honey. I was down till my last I had.
So I just bleached it a little bit. I don't know how this is gonna turn out. I'm just kinda like doing it, you know what I'm saying? I don't really know what I'm doing. Lord, this is probably gonna be a mess. I don't know how this is gonna turn out, y'all. I'm probably about to f*** this shit up. I know it. Don't mind my towel. We're going through some things right now. So I just went through this huge like French onion dip, like I've been craving it, like I need it right now type of phase, right? So I got French onion dip. I didn't even get the halluva kind because they didn't have it at Walmart. I got the Dean's kind, never even seen it before, but it was pretty all right, you know what I'm saying? So I wanted more, like I needed more. I went to the BX and guess what? They had the halluva brand, but guess what? They were out of the French onion, of course. So I'm like, dang, like I'm really craving this, like I really need this. And the lady was like, well, you know, the lady told me like if I take some sour cream and some of this, it'll taste just as good. I'm like looking at her like she was crazy. I'm like, nah, boy, this thing is jumping. Like, boy, this is like A1 sauce. I'm a believer. This is slapping. Like, let me find out. That's all it takes. Okay, so before I figure out what I'm gonna do to this hair, I just want y'all to look at this. This hair does not take bleach well. Y'all saw the curl pattern before of what it was. Mm-mm. Don't bleach it, bitch. So this is literally the curl pattern now. Like, oh my God. So this is a no. I'm gonna do something to it to kind of like give it some life. Cause I liked how it was before, which was like kind of like a braid out. So it's an easy fix as far as that. This is gonna be my experimental hair anyway. But damn, like, I mean, damn, I didn't want it to go, like, flat on me, you know what I'm saying? I didn't want it to go a full, you know?
Track beats. Turn it up.
it literally just got knotted, and I'm like, I'm mad about it. Okay, I don't know what the fuck just happened right there. That's why these damn bantu knots. What is going on here? I can never get bantu knots right, so why would I expect for this to be different? You know what I mean? Why would I expect this to be different? It's no different. This is going terrible. Like, I'm literally cutting off chunks of the hair. Okay, cutting scene. So this bantu knot did not go well at all. It was starting off really good.
Off the start off good, you know, like everything else in the world.
And then all of a sudden, y'all know how bantu knot outs can go. And then I don't know, the hair is just not acting the same ever since it got dyed. And it has like this residue on it. And yes, I put gel in the hair, but the hair shouldn't be feeling like this. So I'm just about to wash it, and we're just gonna start from scratch. And I'm not doing another bantu knot out. I'm literally just about to wash it, comb it out. We're gonna see what's left of the hair, because I have a feeling once I put water on it and like try to wash it, I have a feeling like it's just gonna tangle up, because that's kind of what was happening. I even had to cut hair because of how bad it was tangling, and yet part of it could have been because of me with the bantu knot out, because my natural hair used to get tangled up like that. But then again, no, the color is pretty though, but like it's even getting knotted. Oh yeah, I gotta fix this. It's getting knotted up in there, so I'm about to wash this out, and I'm about to just see, I'm gonna just show y'all what the hair look like. But right now it's like, no, this is pointless, bitch. Just ran it under the shower water, you know, shower water, under my shower and the water, and this is all that came out. Literally, the water was running on the hair, and it was like, you know how like it just was like this in the shower. I'm like, whoa, in the brush, right? I just really feel, I'm thinking about cutting it anyway, because it's too thin, like while it's like in its natural state, because the curl pattern is gone, which is partly expected. I'm not gonna blame it on the company, because I did put bleach on it. However, like, I feel like even if the curl pattern went away, I don't feel like the hair should have just been acting crazy like this. Now my mirror's dirty. I just cleaned it. You know what I mean? I just feel like the hair should still act somewhat decent. This is getting unruly, like, but it's like too thin. I gotta do something. I gotta do something. But like, see? Make sure the brush looked like this before I showed y'all, and
so that's kind of where we're at right now.
So yeah, I think I'm just gonna have to wear it in this flat ass state right now. Yeah, I just is probably what it's gonna be.
What?
Guess what the f happened to me?
What?
I messed up my hair. I'm so mad. You missed it. It was all starting off so well. It was starting off so much good, and then all of a sudden, it just went f***ing left. This is how it turned out after dyeing it. If I pull it onto the front, this is how it looks. It's not a thick unit, but like I said, I don't know, for this look, I don't know, I like thick hair, but for this look, I guess it's pretty all right. I would not suggest dyeing this hair whatsoever, because the curl pattern is gone completely. I mean, it's still cute, like I made it look cute, thank God, but like, you know what I'm saying, like I would not suggest dyeing the hair. It causes shedding, tangling. The hair just can't take it, and I feel like really good hair should be able to take dye with no problem. This hair just can't take it, so I really can't speak on how good the hair is as far as like if it's in its natural state. It felt really good. It was very soft. The hair is still soft. It doesn't have a hard feeling. It's just tangling and shedding, so like I don't know, it's kind of like some mixed emotions. But I don't know, the color came out really pretty. I really don't like thin hair or thin like looks. However, I will say like this, you know, I don't know what you want to call this. I don't even want to call this like a beach wave. This is like, I don't know what this is. But you know, it's kind of cute. You know, that just that sleek, thin, wet look, I guess. But yeah, the color came out cute. It's just this hair doesn't take dye. So the hair is a 360, or the wig is a 360 unit. However, like the way the flaps go, they don't extend far enough for me. Like if I was to wear this to work for like my sideburns not to show. So it's like, you know what I mean? Like as you can see, like my sideburns go farther than this, and it's just like, it just wouldn't work out. So this would be like a wig that I would wear just down, or like if I decide to shave off all my sideburns or whatever, I'd wear it to work then. But as for right now, yeah, I can't wear it to work, so I didn't want to glue it down, because I'm literally gonna put on my other wig and wear that wig to work. But There's no glue. I literally just took the baby hairs that it had and took some gel and just like gelled them. I didn't cut them. I didn't do none of that. I plucked it a little bit, but I barely plucked it. So I guess that's a pro. I really didn't have to do much to the hair as far as like maybe customizing it. So I don't know. Let me know what you guys think in the comment. I don't know if anyone else has ever tried this hair. But I mean, the color is cute. But I don't know, it's just, this hair does not need to be dyed. So I don't know, let me know what you guys think in the comments and I will check you guys with another one. Again, this is Hair Spells. I wanna thank Hair Spells for sending me this hair. I hope you guys like this review. Ooh, jeez, my flap. I hope you guys like this review and I will check you guys with another one.